Everybody, good evening. Happy Friday.
Hello, hello, good evening.
Hi, everybody, good evening.
Good evening.
Hello, good evening. How are you? How's everybody doing? Everybody good?
Yes.
Yes, did you have a good Friday? Todos tuvieron un muy buen, like, end of the week. Let's call it end of the week, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm glad to see you guys. I'm super glad that you are, you know, with us. Today is Friday, the body knows that. So TGIF, y mañana comenzamos, you know, the weekend. So I'm super glad that you're here. I see very good attendance. Veo que tenemos muy buena asistencia. So we're having very good attendance. Teníamos una actividad para el día de ahora, right? We have a little homework assignment que era sobre una experiencia, like a little experience. Vamos a hablar de eso. Vamos ahora a aprovechar que es viernes para tener a lot of speaking practice, right? Especialmente con este tema de simple past. Vamos a revisar some verbs, positive, negative, and speaking, sobre todo. To get started, give me just a second. Vamos a pasar asistencia so we can begin, para escucharlos, para saber que están ahí, and then we start. So give me one second. Ahorita les paso asistencia. Already, so let me get started here. Si me ayudan un momentito con su cámara, that would be wonderful. Así de una sola vez, you know, we can keep it there. Ignacio, hello. Hey, Richard, ahora sí lo veo. Carlos, how you doing, Carlos?
I'm fine.
Norbert, cool to see you. Glad to see you guys. ¿Cómo estuvo de lluvia? ¿Llovió en sus casas? ¿Did rain?
Yes.
Yes, a little, a lot.
No, in Soyapango, it's not rain.
Really? It hasn't rained in Soyapango. Wow, no me imagino el calor. I cannot imagine how hot, how humid está ahorita. Because in San Salvador, in Santa Tecla, it has been raining like crazy, you know. Super, super fuerte. Okay. So, hopefully it's not that hot there. So, guys, let me get started. Me ayuden con el present, please, con la confirmación de asistencia. My first person is Anita. Ana Delmi está por acá. Ana. Creo que todavía no. Brenda. Okay, Brian, por ahí escucha a Brian some seconds ago.
I am here.
Yes, thank you, Brian. Carlos, Charlie boy.
Hello, present.
Thank you very much. Danny Anthony. Creo que se está conectando todavía. Danny Alberto. Danny's? Todavía no, not yet. Okay, Giovanni. Giovanni, let me see, Giovanni. Okay, no veo a Giovanni todavía. Y Guadalupe, por ahí vi a Guadalupe.
Present.
Yes, thank you very much. Jacqueline, Jackie.
Present, teacher.
Gracias, miss. How are you? Everything good in Chalchuapa or in Atiquizaya? Where is it?
Atiquizaya, teacher.
Atiquizaya, wow. ¿Cuándo nos va a llevar a Atiquizaya, miss? Take us there.
Cuando ustedes quieran venir.
Yes. Okay. So, and Ana? Ana and Clary viven en la misma zona. Do you live around? Do you live close?
No,
oh, they live in Ahuachapán. Ah, okay. No, pero podemos dar el tour, you know, para los... Yeah.
Un tour.
Yeah.
Un tour. No vamos a ir a...
teacher, the root flower.
Oh, yeah. So, toda la ruta de las flores. Y venimos a terminar en la Puerta del Diablo, creo que era, right? for the pupusas. That would be wonderful. Okay. Jocelyn. Hi, Jocelyn. I see her right
Hi,
there.
Teacher.
Thank you so much. I'm doing great. Talking about pupusas, you know. Okay. Yeah, I guess I'm just hungry. Ignacio. Thank you, Ignacio, for the confirmation.
Present.
Ahí está. And Norbert. Hey, Norbert.
Present.
Yeah, y nos vamos allá también por los las tierras de Norbert, you know. So that would be the second trip. Marvin Bonilla. Marvin. Hey, Danis. Thank you. Ahorita. Got your attendance right now. Marvin, creo que está en camino. Clary. Claribel, are you around? Creo que todavía no. Moses. Por ahí ve a Moses. If I'm not mistaken.
Present.
Yes. Ahí está. Gracias, Moses. Pedrina.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Yes, Pedrina. Perfect attendance. Cool. René. René, René. Creo que todavía no. He's not there. Okay. Ricardo. Richard.
Present.
Yes. Thank you, Richard. Rodas. Miss Rodas. ¿Está por acá? Por ahí la vi conectada. Yes. Thank you so much. Angel. Give me some confirmation. Yes, Angel. Angel, where do you live?
In Soyapango, teacher.
Ah, okay. Oh, so you are neighbors with Ignacio yes. and with Ingrid. Creo que también vive en Soya. I think she lives in Soya. Okay. Natalie. Let me see. Natalie, are you around? Creí haberla visto hace unos minutitos, but I don't see her anymore. Marvin López. Sandra Flores. Sandra. Oh. Okay. And Ingrid, creería que todavía va en camino a casa. I think she's on her way home. Okay. Okay, everybody. So, iniciamos ahora la clase número 15. So, today is session number 15. Vamos a, you know, try to practice speaking as much as possible con este tema de, you know, experiences, simple past tense. And just let me tell you, estoy muy feliz, you know, I'm pretty happy because los he estado escuchando, you know, hablar inglés. I heard you speak in English, intentando hablar lo menos español posible, comunicándose, and that's what matters. So I'm really happy, and that's what I'm expecting today. Estoy esperando, you know, que de igual forma podamos practicar as much as possible, que intentemos mantenerlo in English, y pues si hay palabras en español, it's okay, pero intentemos, right? De eso se trata todo. So let me present my screen so we can get started. Today, the objective says participants will be able to prepare a conversation about the things they did yesterday at home or at work using simple past. Vamos a hablar de pasados ahora, okay? Every single thing in past, todo lo que hicimos, todas las experiencias, events, good, bad experiences, and things like that. Y tenemos una tareita también que es de nuestras propias experiencias, que era como escribir una breve descripción de lo mejor que nos ha pasado o la peor experiencia con servicios que hayamos recibido, right? To get started, vamos a hacer, oh, wait, me adelanté un poquito. Okay, this is activity number one, okay? It says, write the missing letters to complete the words. Probably easy, probably difficult, I don't know, no sé cómo lo van a encontrar. Okay, so this is a little exercise para que revisemos algunos, algunas palabras that we have checked during this module. So, si tienen el material a la mano, if you have the material at hand, take out your material, okay? Revísenlo, take it out. Saquen the words, you know, the vocabulary, y veamos cuáles son las letras que nos faltan. What are the letters that we are missing here? For example, number one. ¿Qué puede ser la primera? What do you think can be number one? What are the missing letters? ¿Qué letras hacen falta en el ejercicio uno? What are the missing letters? Esta es una palabra. Esta es la segunda palabra que es up, right? So what is word number one? What is the verb number one?
Pick.
Very good, exactly. Pick up, okay. Como levantar, recoger. So pick up the, el que va a recoger. What are you going to pick up?
Where?
Pick up the?
Tree.
Oh, pick up the tree.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's possible. Okay. So pick up the T-H-R-E-E. Oh, yes. Yes, it makes sense. Very good. Hey, you're good. Okay, so pick up the tree. Que recoge el árbol, right?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. What about the others? ¿Qué nos hace falta en los demás? What is missing in the rest?
P-O-U? Pull?
In number two? P?
Ah, number two. B-U. Bye.
Oh, again, this is W-H. Oh, why? Okay. Oh. So number two puede ser why. ¿Hay otra posibilidad? Is there another possibility? ¿Alguien tiene algo diferente?
Bye.
Bye. Okay. Bye. Yes, that makes sense too.
También puede ser T-R.
Try.
Yes. Bye. Try. Okay. Pagar, how do you say pagar?
Yes.
Pay, también pay. Exactly, excellent. Any other? I think we're good. I think we're good. Number three, bye. What a bye.
Puede ser, ahí puede ser cal, o sea, sea.
Cool, de llamar a alguien. Yeah. Perfect, wow, you're good. Cool.
También puede ser tel.
Tell, very good, yes. Yeah. How do you say alar? Like, do this. How do you say alar?
Yes.
In English, ¿cómo decimos alar? How do you say alar in English?
Pull.
Pull, también puede ser pull, exactly. Okay, okay. What about four? Any possibility in number four? Yes, Ignacio?
Puede ser tall.
También podría ser, it could be here. I mean, no tenemos como que tienen que ser solo verbos o solo adjetivos or anything. So yes, puede ser también tall. Okay, yeah, makes sense. What about number four? ¿Cuál podemos usar en number four, Guadalupe?
No, for number three, walk. Walk.
Oh, wall de pared, wall. Yes, okay, yes, okay. Okay, I like it, very nice. So, estamos creando más palabras. We are making more words, okay? Now, number four. Any possibility with number four? What do you think? Pueden revisar su material. You can check your material. You can open it up.
Teacher, maybe four. New prize.
Oh, very good. New prizes. Exactly. Ya tenemos la S, right? Okay, perfect. New prizes. Okay. ¿Alguien más? Any other possibility? ¿O nos quedamos con new prizes?
Get prices.
Get.
Get
prices get. También funciona. Get prices. Okay. So new prices, get prices. All right. Yeah.
Or maybe new prongs.
New pro.
Prongs.
Prongs.
Pronombres nuevos. No sé. New
prongs. No cabe.
Ah, no.
Falta una letra.
Y falta un espacio.
Dos letras, nos faltarían dos letras. But you're good. Get prices, new prices, estamos súper bien. Number five, what about number five? Who helps me with number five?
Mm. teacher.
Yeah.
It's correct. Let primes.
Let primes.
Let
price, de la palabra prices.
Prices.
Sí. Let prices. Pues sí se podría, solo que es un poco extraño, porque let es como permitir. Entonces, let prices suena como permitir precios, pero...
No cabe, tiene como, tampoco.
I mean, sí se podría, en la número 4, right? Number 4 podría ser, pero okay, quizás necesitamos más contexto, necesitamos más información, porque se ve un poquito raro. But yes, okay, it could work.
Mm-hmm. In the fight, teacher, yes. Maybe explain.
Oh, very good. Explain. Okay. Cuando explicamos algo, right? Okay. Explain something. Very nice. So, what about number 6? Anybody with number 6? I'm gonna write them here. No idea for number 6.
En la 3 también fell.
Tell, ¿es esa acá? This one?
Fell, yes.
Oh, fell, de caerse, ok. Fall and fell, ok, el pasado de caer, ok, yes, yes. Sí funciona, of course, we can use it, that's good. What about number 6? Si no tenemos de número 6, no hay problema, sigamos con la number 7. So, any idea, ¿qué se les viene a la mente con el número 7? What comes to your mind with number 7?
I know, Jocelyn?
Fel, de sentir.
Help, ayuda.
Oh, help. So, help. Creo que lo escuché. Fel. Ok, el pasado de sentir.
No, help.
Help de ayuda. Okay, okay, okay.
Help.
Fell.
So help. Felt. Sorry. Help. Felt. ¿Qué más se les viene a la mente?
Self.
What is it, Guadalupe?
Self.
How do you spell that?
S. Mm-hmm. E. L F.
Oh yes, okay, cell. Yeah, okay. Oh my God, yeah, you're right. Yes.
Number 2.
Mm-hmm.
And side.
Oh, the decir.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, hay muchas más palabras. Yeah, you're right. Yes. So say as well. Okay. So here we have held, felt, sail. All right. What about number 8?
Cell. Sí.
Cell. Como de una celda.
Celda or yes, or, mm-hmm. or example in Excel. Cell. Mm-hmm.
Cell. Yeah. Como una celda. Got it. Okay. Yeah, that can work as well. Mm-hmm. What about number 8, guys? ¿Qué se les viene a la mente con el número 8? What comes to your mind? Number 8.
Assistant.
Assist. It works. Okay. Assist. La forma cortita. Assist. Mm-hmm. Assist. Excellent. Mm-hmm. Yes, miss.
Number 10, understand.
Oh, very good. Yes, of course. So understand. Okay. Nice. Number 9 or el resto de ellas? Number 6, number 11, number 12. Anybody?
Receiver.
Number 9, receive. Veamos. Receive. Yes. Received. Very good. Recibir algo. Ok. Ok. Now, what about number six? ¿Cómo digo when I don't like something? When I don't like a service, I don't like a product, and I talk to the manager. Yeah. What is the word? How do you talk about that? What is the word that we can use? When you don't like a product, you don't like a service, and you're like, can I talk to your manager? Look, I don't, I'm not happy. Yeah, but what is the word? It begins with C. I'm not happy with your service. I'm not happy with your company. What is this? What do you do? I'm gonna give you one more letter. O, M, com. In Spanish, cuando no les gusta algo, what do you do?
Molestia.
Yeah, but okay. For example, when you are angry, when you are angry with Claro, Tigo, you call them, yeah? And you tell them, look, I am paying for a service and you are not giving me the service. What do you do? ¿Cómo se llama eso? How do you call that?
Complain.
Complain, exactly. Complain. So that is quejarse, right? We complain. We Salvadorian complain a lot. Nos quejamos de todo. We complain because of the weather, the gasoline, the Bitcoin,
the decline, everything.
Okay. Complain. Eso es quejarse. Very good. 11 or 12. ¿Quién tiene la 11 o la 12? Who has 11 or 12?
Maybe the first word is around.
Okay, around. Uh-huh. That could work.
Maybe the second is once.
Okay, around once.
Around once.
Good night, Miss.
Hey, Ingrid. Good evening. Hello, Miss. How are you?
Information in this neighborhood.
Don't forget.
Information. Oh, information. Okay. Yeah. So, la última es information. ¿Y la de arriba? What about the one on top?
Around one's information.
Okay, around one's information, pero hay un espacio por acá. Probablemente tengamos que cambiar. Provide. Okay, very good.
Provedor.
So provide, que dé información. Provide. Ahora sí. Y la que decía Ignacio, provide one's information, okay? Yes. So, que probamos nuestra información personal, right? So, cuando le dicen, please provide your information. So, provide your information, like, proporciona su información personal, right? That would be the one. Already, y la última, guys, what about the last? Wait, I'm gonna move it because it's okay. I think it's better. What about the last?
Information también.
La última, sí, la número 11, it's information. What about number 12?
También la 12, information.
Okay, podría ser, you know, so information for number 12. Y la primera palabra, what about the first word? Como cuando yo pido. How do you say pedir?
Receive.
Request. Perfect. Request. Okay. So que yo pido, yo solicito. Request information. Okay. So, hey, you know, Ingrid, I need to request some of your information. Necesito pedirle, right? Necesito solicitarle. Excellent job, guys. Very good.
Por fin.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, toman tiempo, but they are super good for vocabulary because we can practice.
Con el cerebro fresco ahorita mismo.
Viene con el cerebro sharp. Listo. Filudo, as we said. Okay, amazing. Now, vamos a hacer un breve recordatorio de esta parte. Write adjectives to show a customer's satisfaction and the satisfaction about a product. Necesito palabras, ¿ok? Que describan. Oh, guys, I'm sorry. ¿Me logran escuchar? Can you listen to me?
Yes.
Me estoy quebrando. Ok, es que mi cámara se está quebrando. My camera is breaking. No. Ok, no sé qué pasa de repente. So, satisfaction. Cuando me gusta un servicio, un producto, ¿qué palabras utilizo para decir que estuvo genial? Que me siento good. Que nice. Es cómodo, que esto es nice. Pero cuando yo me siento enojada, when I'm very angry, when I'm not happy with a service, uso palabras un poco hirientes, un poco fuertes, you know? Like, for example, you say, oh, Tigo, es mi referente, sorry. And you say, for example, oh, Tigo is a bad company, pero yo uso palabras para mostrar mi dissatisfaction, right? Like, oh, it is all awful, okay? It is disgusting. It is a waste of time. So vamos a utilizar aquí, vamos a hacer una listita de palabras bonitas, beautiful words to say when you are happy and not beautiful words to show your dissatisfaction, okay? So beautiful, not beautiful words. I'll give you 2 minutes. Le voy a dar 2 minutitos para que escribamos cómo ustedes expresan dissatisfaction about a product, right? For example, if I have to talk about, no sé qué producto, I don't know what company todos hemos consumido and we are not happy with. For example, for me, Banco Agrícola. In dissatisfaction, I can include Banco Agrícola. And una de las palabras que puedo decir is slow, right? Slow. For me, it's like, oh, cuando pienso en el Banco Agrícola, I'm like, oh, my God. Yeah, payday, Banco Agrícola, no, it's a slow. No. Para mí es demasiado lento, right? It's a slow. ¿Qué otras palabras puedo utilizar para show my dissatisfaction? Slow, but customer service.
But
seguro.
Safe.
No, sure.
Or dangerous.
No, dangerous.
Safe or dangerous, exactly. Yeah. Clean. O lo opuesto de clean, dirty, right?
Dirty.
Mm-hmm.
Dirty.
Like pleasant, un lugar que es muy agradable, pleasant. Or disgusting, un lugar que es súper feo, desagradable. Oh. So disgusting. So I'll give you 2 minutes. Les voy a dar 2 minutitos. Give you 2 minutes.
Satisfaction and dissatisfaction. Teacher, solo adjetivos.
Hello, yes, solo the only adjectives.
Okay.
Are you ready? Did everybody finish? Do you need more time? ¿Cuántos adjetivos tienen? How many adjectives do you have? I'll give you one more minute.
Only one.
Oh, okay. So, pensamos un poquito en aquellas palabras como describirían un servicio, right? Que fue excelente, so we can use words like those. Excelente, maravilloso, aceptable, ajá, bueno.
My one adjective is a positive.
Okay.
Punctuality.
Okay.
Is for laboratory of treatment water.
Oh.
Leg. Mm-hmm. Yeah, in the laboratory.
Pensé que leg era de ojos. I don't know why. Okay. So, comfortable, for example. Si un lugar fue cómodo, agradable, ameno. So, I mean, there are a lot of words that we can use to express
super clear.
Uh-huh. Y también yeah. Para satisfaction. Like, for example, lo opuesto de puntual, punctual. Lo opuesto de responsable y responsible. Because estamos categorizando satisfaction, no solamente de comida, sino también puede ser en un servicio que les fue propuesto. Oh. Cuando van, por ejemplo, al mecánico, cuando van al banco, cuando van a una escuela o pagan la escuela de sus hijos, you know. Yes, Ignacio.
And my dissatisfaction is adjective is warm for warm. The air warm.
Okay, warm like the weather. Warm.
Yes, warm. Okay. When the air condition is not function
mm-hmm.
in the office.
Okay.
AC.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because the AC has to work. Okay, I got it. That's already. One more minute, guys. Y pensemos en todos los servicios, you know, o lugares que hayan visitado. So, all the places, not only food. También podemos agregar como delicious, bland, que es insípido, you know, or anything que se les ocurra. Expensive, cheap.
For example, quickly.
quickly.
Yes, exactly, like fast. Quickly. When you get a service really fast.
Service and attention.
Service and attention, okay. For example, let me see, Subway. I think that Subway is really fast.
Yes.
So, for me, that's fast.
In 5 minutes, you have your Subway.
Yes, Subway for me is fast, exactly. But Pizza Hut for me is very slow. So it's like the opposite.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So podemos pensar en eso, you know.
Teacher, they promise the 12 or 15 minutes
mm-hmm.
and to use 20 or 25 maybe.
Yeah, that's right. So they are very slow.
The is very lonely.
Slowly, de lento, slowly.
Yeah, okay. Is.
What is the name?
I-triple-S.
Oh, la Seguro Social.
Yeah.
Oh, well, creo que in my experience, Seguro Social goes with all the characteristics of dissatisfaction. I don't know you guys. What can you tell me about Seguro Social? What are your thoughts?
Nothing satisfaction.
What comes to your mind?
But service.
But service.
People angry.
The personal.
The customer service. Okay. Have you ever gone to Seguro Social? Okay, but
teacher,
service. Yeah.
Teacher, in the Seguro Social, waste time.
Okay, you will waste time. Okay. What else? Moses, ¿qué me puede agregar a Seguro Social? What can you add?
Stressful.
Yeah. Okay, I agree. Yeah. Anything else? I have to say it. It's dirty. So the
yes.
I think the place is kind of dirty. Como descuidado, you know, kind of old, in bad condition.
Inappropriate vocabulary.
Really?
Yes.
Lo han maltratado. Like boring, es aburrido, okay?
From the personal security or reception.
What is it, Moses?
They are pedantic.
Yes.
Kind of rude, como muy, okay, podemos usar la palabra rude. Rude no es como rudo, sino que rude es eso, como maleducados, you know, como pésimo. Okay, really?
Attention.
What is the word?
Prepotente.
Yeah, podemos usar rude. We can use rude for that, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, wow, okay. So, eso sí no me ha pasado. I didn't know about that, and I'm sorry you had that experience.
It is a requirement for the job.
No, I don't think so. But I agree, it is a stressful. It's a very stressful place. Okay, ¿qué más tienen? What other satisfaction or dissatisfaction words do you have? Vamos primero con satisfaction. Tell me the place.
Pleasant.
Yeah?
Comfortable.
Yes.
Okay, comfortable. What place?
Pleasant, como...
Pleasant, como agradable. Mm-hmm.
Pleasant, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Nice.
Nice.
Let's go with Jocelyn. The word was comfortable. ¿Cuál es el lugar? What is the place?
Comfortable is a hotel.
Oh, a hotel. Okay.
Sorry, hotel.
Okay. What hotel? Which hotel?
Bar La Ceibita.
Bar La Ceibita. No, a hotel.
Yes.
Do you remember?
Super over.
Do you remember the name of the hotel?
Del. Es que se me olvida el nombre.
Oh, okay. It's okay. It's fine. So comfortable, a hotel, a pleasant. Danny said a bar. Ingrid. Ingrid.
Hello.
Yes. ¿Cuál era la palabra? What was the word? ¿Cuál era la palabra, miss?
Nice.
Nice, okay. Satisfaction. ¿Qué otra palabra podemos usar? Amazing, you said.
Yes.
Wow, okay, amazing. ¿Cuál es el lugar? What is the place?
Koi. It's a restaurant to Japan fusion food.
Ah, okay. Amazing. Wow. So es una palabra fuerte. That's a very like, okay. So amazing, like super bueno. Wow. Okay. Any other? So, si ya no tenemos, vamos ahora con dissatisfaction. Ya describimos el seguro social. So I guess we described all the bad things. But any other word que se nos haya quedado? Any other adjective you have?
Disagreeable.
Disagreeable, okay, yes.
Teacher.
Yeah?
En el seguro social no todo es malo.
No.
Yeah, I don't know.
No,
incapacidad. For example,
good personnel.
The body, the employee.
The surgery and serious illness. You know.
Okay, surgeries and serious illness. Yeah, Seguro Social has good professionals.
Attend very well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I have, the thing is that, you know, if we compare Seguro Social in hospitals, yo tengo en muy alta estima los hospitales, you know, especially San Rafael Hospital. I think it's one of the best in El Salvador. I don't know why.
Rosales?
Mm-hmm. I have,
son lentos.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's
good.
I mean, I'm talking about San Rafael because he tenido familiares ahí, you know, and the service is really good. Yeah. And it's a public hospital. But for Seguro example, Social...
For example, my fourth son is born in El Seguro Social.
Ah, Seguro Social, okay. And what about the service? Was it good? Was the service good?
Super good.
Okay, amazing. I'm glad. I'm happy to hear that. That sounds good. Because, I mean, we are kind of paying for the service, right? So I'm happy about it. Okay, good. Now, guys, vamos a mover un poquito de tema. Vamos a ir con pasados. We are going to move a little bit with simple past. Okay. But to complete this exercise, I think it's kind of easy. Ya están los verbos ahí, en los espacios that are missing. Y vamos a hacerlo en pasado. We are going to do, or we are going to tell the story. Vamos a contar esta historia en pasado, right? Voy a estar llamando a algunos. I'm going to be calling some. Así que me ayudan, please. Help me out with the past verbs. Fill in the blanks with the right form of the verbs in brackets. And it says, last Eastern holidays, Jimmy and Paul. Go, Guadalupe.
When?
Yes, continue, please. Continue reading. Ayúdenme a leerlo.
Okay. Went camping in the mountain. Mm-hmm. They spent a wonderful time there.
Perfect. Let's go hiking más. Select another person.
Ricardo.
Hi.
Hello, Ricardo. Help us, please. Desde acá. Day.
¿Dónde nos quedamos en day?
Day.
Ese se me olvidó.
Guys, alguien que le ayude. Somebody wants to help.
Wait.
Tenemos day, no. Pero es wake, de levantarse, despertar. Day.
They woke up.
Yeah. They woke up.
What?
Wake up.
Como en presente, wake up, en pasado, woke up. They woke up.
They woke up early in the morning and they.
And they went
for a walk in the village dates. ¿Cómo se dice esa palabra? Villa.
In the village.
Yes.
Perfect. That's okay. Thank you, Richard. Next person. Selecciona el siguiente. Select next person.
No, mejor por número, teacher. No.
No, así, go. No, no me gusta, yeah, no me select gusta, the no person. Me gusta.
No, número cinco, ahí.
Hey, I am.
Number five.
Okay. Wait, es que no lo
sé. Me siento culpable después.
No, no se sienta culpable. Don't feel guilty. Next person is Jocelyn. Thank you, Jocelyn. Okay.
Okay. Welcome in the village. The both. Everything the need needed mm-hmm. in the afternoon they played football, mm-hmm. watched the birds and swimming in the river.
Okay, awesome, very good. Now the past of swim, solo hagamos el cambio.
Swimming? Ah, no, no.
Swam.
Pasado de swim is swim.
Swam.
Exactly. Very good. Con A, exactly. Good. Next person, Jocelyn, escoja el siguiente, please. Select next person.
Jackie.
Hello. Jackie. Yo creo que Jacqueline tenía problemas con el Inter. Vi por ahí hace un momento que la había sacado. But no sé si ya nos escucha. Jacqueline, are you around? Creería que todavía no. Okay, another person. ¿Alguien más? Anybody else? I'm going to take Norberto. Because I don't think Jackie's here. Norbert, ayúdenos, please. Help us. Hey, Marvin, good evening.
Hi, teacher.
Hello. Marvin, hábleme cuando entre. Say hello when you come. A veces no lo logro ver que está conectado because no me aparece la notificación hasta que empiezo, you know. But I'm glad. Gracias por estar con nosotros. René, hello. I'm glad you're here. Clary, hello, Clary. Sorry, no le había saludado, pero ya vi su mensajito. Me. Okay. Natalie, hello, Giovanni, hey guys, I'm glad you're there, Brenda, Delmi, hey, we almost got everybody, all right, hello, I'm glad, teacher. Hello guys,
hello teacher,
hi guys, hableme, say hello to me, okay, so, no sé, creo que Norbert se ha levantado por el momento, Brenda, ya que la tengo por acá. Oh, thank you, Norbert. Ayúdenme acá, please. They
and her.
¿En pasado? They didn't.
Ah, they didn't.
Yes, they didn't.
ATVs. Said to have their dinner. Mm-hmm. They.
Acá, ese verbo. Talk. Spike. Podemos usar el pasado de talk. They talked. Ellos hablaron.
Oh, they talked for a week and stay.
Mm-hmm.
Went to sleep.
Okay. Amazing. Thank you. Thank you very much. Anita, Ana Paola, help me with the last, please.
Yes, teacher.
One night.
se quedó en...
One night.
Ahí tengo que empezar, teacher.
Yes, please.
Yes. one night Jimmy have a very strange dream.
Yeah.
They was.
La otra. They
were.
Yes.
By the river watching the moon.
Yes, very good.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Excellent job, everybody. Exactly. So here, en una forma bien corta, ya contaron una historia. O ya contamos una historia. So, revisemos un par de verbos acá. Me gustó mucho que ya se sabía en el pasado de spend. Very good. Solamente repitamos. Spend, spent.
Spent.
Spent. De gastar, ¿verdad? I spent. Yo gasté o yo me quedé. I spent a weekend. Mm-hmm. El pasado de buy. By bought. Play, played.
Played.
Otra vez. Play, played.
Play, played.
Very good. Now, el negativo de have. Didn't have.
Didn't have.
Exactly. Remember, negativos usamos didn't. Very good. Good, good, everybody. Now, it is kind of, vamos a hacer un poquito de negative transformations and everything en un momento, but antes de irnos con esta parte, before going into this, vamos a hacer un poquito de speaking practice. Yesterday, veíamos la pregunta, when was the last time? ¿Cuándo fue la última vez? When was the last time you did this activity? Today, tengo un par de preguntitas for you, and of course, ayer veíamos yesterday, last Monday, last month, yesterday morning, etc. Now, vamos a practicar un poquito, and we are going to give details, of course. Question one says, when was the last time you drank coffee? When was the last time you drove for more than 2 hours? When was the last time you dyed your hair? Dye in English means change the color. So when was the last time you changed the color, no worries, Ignacio, of your hair? ¿Alguna vez se han teñido el cabello? Have you ever colored your hair? When was the last time? When was the last time you fell? People, what is the meaning of fell? ¿Qué significa fell? What is this? Fell?
Caer.
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que se cayó? Right? When was the last time you felt really happy? Like very happy, really happy. Or the last time you forgot where something important was, como cuando se les olvidan las llaves, yeah, your keys, your money. A mí se me olvida mucho el ID, el DUI. So I forget my DUI all the time. ¿El que se le olvidó, Guadalupe? What did you forget?
My cell phone.
Your cell phone. No, but forgot it, like forgot it. Okay. When was the last?
Me puedo olvidar cualquier cosa menos eso.
Exactly. Exactly. doy como una vuelta. Okay. ¿Dónde me vine? ¿A dónde estuve? And I start like coming back in time. Okay. When was the last time I got a gift? What is the meaning of gift? What is a gift? Number 7.
Regalo.
Un regalo, a present, exactly. When was the last time you got, que usted recibió un regalo? So, when was the last time you got a gift? What did you get? Money, flowers, roses, a cup, a blouse, a shirt, what did you get? And when was the last time you had a headache, right? That you're like, I have a headache. Don't talk to me. So we are going to talk about, really? But headache, no migraine. Are you having a headache, Carlos?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
A very difficult day.
Oh, stressful?
Yes.
Wow, I'm sorry to hear about that. Are you working tomorrow?
Yes, every day.
Wow, that's hard. What about Sunday? Are you working on Sunday?
No, Sunday is my holiday.
Day off. Okay. No, my holiday. Friends, on Sunday, váyase a vagar. Go away, you know. Yeah, forget about the routine. I know, it's hard sometimes. You know, jobs are stressful sometimes. I understand. So, vamos a trabajar en grupos. Le pueden tomar captura. You can take a picture and let's go. Let's get ready for these. We have 5-7 minutes to practice and then we come back, right? So, let's get going. Vámonos. Let's get going, please. Guys, intenten practicar tanto como puedan, right? Si alguien habla más que el otro, no se preocupen. Usted intente con su ritmo, but try. No se me quede calladito, please. Don't keep quiet. Give your opinion. Try. Tómese su tiempo to say it. It's fine. So, let's go. Go, go, go.
Pondremos una iluminación en cada salón y las computadoras llegarán en septiembre.
For more than 2 hours. Drove es como manejar, va. Pasado.
Sí, fue drive es manejar.
Yes, that is correct. So drive is present and drive is the past. Uh-huh. When was the last time you drove for more than 2 hours?
I don't know, try.
Okay. Okay. Oh, but it's okay. So when was the last time you were in a bus or in a car for more than 2 hours? Not necesariamente que manejó, but when was the last time you were in a car for 2 hours?
And the last Monday in the bus.
For 2 hours.
Yes.
Why?
For the traffic. The traffic in Los Chorros.
Wow. So you were coming from Los Chorros to Santa Tecla and you were in the bus for 2 hours. Wow.
1 hour of
time
until Delicias.
Wait, into una hora de dónde? 1 hour from where?
Santa Tecla, Delicias.
From Santa Tecla, like el centro de Santa Tecla, to Las Delicias.
Entrada de la carretera, de Delicias.
Oh my God. Ay, quizás yo me bajo usted. Oh my goodness. You know, es que yo soy bien, I'm not very patient with traffic. I don't like traffic. So I don't know. Quizás yo me hubiese bajado. I'm very crazy. Okay. Okay, very interesting. But wow. What about now, Guadalupe? Is traffic better?
Now?
Yeah, like these days. Is it faster? Es más rápido?
No.
The same.
Today, raining is pesado.
Okay, so you have heavy traffic. Yeah, and also it's Friday. So Fridays are more difficult.
Friday, yes, it's difficult.
Got it.
No.
tal? Marvin, tell us, Marvin. Talk to
Hi,
us.
Teacher.
Hello. Talk to us, Marvin.
Number one. When was the last day you drink coffee? I was the last day drunk.
I'm so sorry. What was that? Siento que se me cortó. Marvin, hello. Siento que se me cortó la idea. So I was like,
¿me escucha?
Sí, es que lo escuché cortadito, pero de repente yo veo que mi cámara se queda también cortada, entonces no sé si es mi internet.
Pero sí me escuchan las demás compañeras. Sí.
Le escuché cortado también, un poco cortado.
Okay, so tell us, repítanos, tell us one more time.
Repeat.
Okay. No perdemos nada. We don't lose anything.
I was the last day drink coffee. Now afternoon in my house.
Oh, okay. So the last time was today in the afternoon. Got it. What about number two? When was the last time you drove for more than 2 hours?
I don't drive.
You don't drive.
I don't know. Okay. I don't have.
You don't have a car.
Yes.
But what about the last time you were in a bus for 2 hours? Hi, Ignacio. Hi, Danis.
I'm back here.
Okay, I'm Hi. Glad. Me alegra verlo de regreso. I'm glad you're back. Hello.
I'll come back.
Cool. I'm glad you're back. So, estamos acá practicing the questions with the guys. I'm happy you are here, so you can also practice with them. Nos vemos en unos minutitos. Yeah, see you in some minutes.
Okay. Pema.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your health car.
Sorry, repeat.
You have cars.
Yes, I have a car. I drive my car for 2 hours.
Okay, very well. And you, Carlos?
No, I don't have a car. I don't drive it.
Okay.
Another question. When yes. was the last time you felt really happy?
Fear. Sintió feliz, sintió una felicidad.
Se sintió muy contento. O realmente feliz.
Okay. In today, for celebration the Father's Day, which company?
Oh,
and you, Brendan?
No te escuché.
is the question. The question
five. No, I don't have a question. A question. A question.
The question is, when was the last time you felt really happy?
I felt happy today and why? Yesterday.
Why?
I don't know. Así soy feliz. Así que siempre me siento feliz.
Oh,
okay, very well.
No tengo razones.
You are the reason.
Yes.
Yourself. Okay. Yourself.
Yes, yes, yes.
Usted misma.
Así soy feliz.
Okay.
En Ingrid.
Yes, I like it.
I am very happy every day.
Just when I'm drunk. But what about like very, very happy, really happy?
Really?
That time you were really happy.
What?
Es que no le creo que no se enoje, you know. Guys, what do you think? They don't know what to say. So,
no, teacher.
Como, I'm going to say something. So, no.
No, es. How do you say, es raro que me enoje?
It's not very common. It's not very common.
Deme la receta, por favor.
Yes.
Please tell us. Pues, compartirnos.
Pues no tener más.
What do you do?
Ah, vaya. Yo creo que esa fue la mejor respuesta que me pudo dar.
Oh my God.
Esa es una de las claves.
Sí, sí. Yo creo que.
I have heard. Oh my God.
Yo creo que lo voy a tomar en cuenta.
Eso.
No,
pensé
cierto.
Que me iba a decir, no sé, tomar agua.
Respirar.
Es entendible, mis, es entendible. Mis.
Okay.
Por eso, okay. Ah, pues entonces, hoy sí entiendo por qué verdaderamente feliz.
¿Verdad?
Okay, no. I feel I received too much information. Okay. So let's move on. Okay. Oh, that was about being happy. Guys, what about number six? When was the last time you forgot where something important was? What did you forget? Okay. One day, I forgot my cell phone in the car, but it was in the back. Lo puse atrás del asiento. I put it in the back of the car. And then for those días, for 2 days, I didn't find my cell phone.
Oh.
Yeah, that was crazy.
And your cell phone was in mute.
Yeah, my cell phone is always in mute, but pensé que lo había perdido. I thought my cell phone was lost or was stolen. So this is why, dejé de buscarlo. I stopped looking for my phone. But then, no sé cómo se me ocurrió, I remember, and I was like, okay, I'm going to check. And I found it. Okay, that was crazy. What about you? When was the last time?
Otro,
no. Because me había resignado. I said, oh no, no voy a comprar otro. I'm not going to buy another phone. Mm-hmm. But I found it, yes. What about you guys? When was the last time you forgot where something important was?
Make a report? No.
No, but like, for example, cuando olvida, no algo, sino, yeah, exactly, an object.
Cuando olvida.
Pero ¿dónde lo puso? Where you put it? Like your glasses, like your money. Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
The last time I forget when keep away a check for pay taxes.
You forgot?
When I was keep away, no, put away a check to pay taxes.
You forgot the check. You forgot where you put the check.
Yes.
Oh, was it a little or a lot of money?
3 miles of dollar.
3,000?
Yes.
$3,000. Oh my God. A little money. Wow. Okay. But did you find the money?
Yes, I find in all papers in my, how do you say, gavetas?
In your drawers. Se lo voy a escribir, in the drawer. Wow. Okay, good.
In the drawers and papeleras. ¿Cómo se dice papeleras?
Yeah, some drawers. Those some drawers. In the shelves, in the drawers. Okay.
In all drawers of my office. And my company next to.
Okay. Wow. Guys, what about you? Norberto, when was the last time you forgot something? Where something was? También está René, but creo que René está trabajando, right? Norberto?
In my work. Forgot, ¿cómo dice llave?
The keys.
The keys in my desk.
Okay, but did you find them? Las encontró, did you find them?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so me quedé esperando. Okay, got it. Ingrid, what about you? When was the last time you forgot where something was?
Estoy recordando, miss.
Oh, you're in process, okay. Brenda, are you forgetful?
La pregunta.
I do not remember.
Okay, you don't remember. She doesn't remember. Yes, Ingrid?
Ya me acordé, pero no sé cómo formularlo, o sea... lo mismo, las llaves. ¿Cómo se dice las llaves?
Keys.
Keys in the cashier at my work. Y es forget in the restaurant.
You forget them. You put them. Oh, wait. So you had the keys, but you put them in the restaurant.
I forgot las llaves.
The keys
in the cashier.
Okay.
De la caja, the cashier. Yeah. In the restaurant.
Okay.
Food court de la Plaza Mundo.
In the food court.
Yes. Wow. Hace poco me pasó eso.
Wow. Y ya
cuando iba a entrar de almorzar.
In English.
No las andaba.
You're doing a good job in English. Keep it up, okay?
So
you went to lunch, I believe. You have lunch. In the food court.
No sé cómo formular. In the restaurant.
Okay.
And forget.
Cuéntenos lo que nos acaba de contar, que cuando se regresó se dio cuenta. Okay. Tell us that information in English. Podemos usar return, porque como es regresar, ¿verdad? When I returned to the agency.
the agency, the agency.
Agency.
Y, me la buscaba, pero no sé cómo se dice así.
Ajá. Buscar es,
y no las encontraba.
Buscar es look for. Look for. So I looked. I looked. For the keys. Ajá. ¿Cómo digo no las encontré, guys? I didn't.
I looked for the keys.
Mm-hmm. I looked for the keys. Yes, I didn't find them. Yo no las encontré. Exactly. Uh-huh. I didn't find them. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
Bueno, es que no sé cómo hacer la plática. Es decir, que me regresé, fui a buscarlas allá al restaurante y regresé.
I looked for the keys. Esta misma palabra. I looked for the keys. Yo las busqué. I looked for the keys.
I looked for the keys.
¿A dónde la buscó?
En restaurant.
Okay.
Food court.
Okay.
I am years. Y me las entregó. O sea, la chica me las entregó.
Oh, a guard. Okay.
A guard.
Uh-huh. ¿Cómo digo me las dio? ¿Cómo digo dar?
Give.
Give. Yes. El pasado de give es. El pasado de gave. Exactly. Recuérdese de gave, que se parece a otra palabra. So a girl gave them to me. Mm-hmm.
Hoy sí me trabé con todo. Con
no, mí es al contrario. Está haciendo like a big, big thing porque ya está intentando comunicar ideas completas, pero lo está haciendo súper bien. So a girl gave them to me. Una chica me las dio. Mm-hmm. So, you are doing fine. You're doing fine. Solamente, debemos de trabajar los verbos, right? So, we have to memorize the verbs, and that's it. But very good. Very good job. Guys, los dejo practicar un momento más, and I'll see you in a bit. Nos vemos en un momentito.
Among, no sé cómo se dice.
Solamente.
Okay. Only.
Okay.
Yes.
And you, Pedri,
me había informado.
Hello, Pedrina.
Está ocupada, quizás.
Thank you guys. So thank you for coming back. I know that we were like practicing a little bit some of the questions. I'm sorry, me mutié. Okay. So we were practicing these questions and Believe me, you're doing a very good job. Solamente es de ordenar como sometimes our ideas, you know, think a little bit about este orden de sujeto verbo. I went, I did, I studied, but you're doing a very good job trying to communicate. So están haciendo un esfuerzo huge, you know, enorme, and that is very nice. So let's take a look at a couple of them. First, I have a question for you that is number 5. When was the last time you felt really happy? ¿Alguien nos quiere contar the last time you were really happy about something? ¿Cuándo estuvieron muy felices? ¿Excited? ¿Qué les today. Pasó? What happened? What, why? Why?
My daughter is happy.
Okay.
Or in the world is very nice.
Oh, okay.
Or I listen to music.
Okay.
I listen to my music.
Okay. So you feel happy?
Yeah. Yes.
Wow. Okay. Yes. That's a nice feeling. Okay.
Yes.
And so your daughter is happy. Your job is good. You listen to music. That is happiness for you.
My favorite pet. My pet.
Your pet? Uh-huh. Okay. Okay, having time with
recite.
Your friends.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Recite.
The tail. So it's a dog. The dog.
Yes,
so
yes.
The dog was like moving its tail. Okay. It was banging the tail. Yeah, Ignacio?
Yeah, my feel really happy day is the five young. Because
why?
It was my birthday.
Wow, really? Congratulations. Yeah. Hey, that was very recent. So congrats. Okay, so you were happy on that day, I imagine. Me. Yeah.
Me
yeah, tell me, Ingrid.
Yeah. It sería, I have my children.
The day you had your children.
Yes. Yes.
That is the happiest. Amazing. Thank you.
Yes,
you did it nicely. Oh. Very good. The day I had my children.
Exactly.
Ya le van a hacer más sinapsis, no se preocupe.
Ya puede dormir.
Ya puede dormir tranquila. No, you did it nicely.
No,
yes.
Mis, ya no crecen las neuronas. Ya
pero
no,
pero hacen más sinapsis, así que, in a way, we push them, las presionamos.
Científicamente, you know, dicen de que uno ya nace con las neuronas que le toca a cada quien, entonces creo que ya me murió la última.
Oh, but you know, aprender otro idioma evita Alzheimer. Y potencia el cerebro. Yeah, comprobado. Yes. Así que you're doing a good job. Yes, yes.
Teacher, one moment, if they feel really happy for some of the classmate, she say me for salary increase.
Oh, yes. Who was that person?
Two years ago.
Oh, 2 years ago. Not this year. Who was very happy with your promotion? Who was very happy with the salary increase? I mean, I get happy, but that is not the happiest day. Uh-huh. Who was very happy? Nobody? You don't remember?
No, I don't know.
Guadalupe, really? Yeah. It was you.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I smiles from ear to ear. Okay.
I did say drinking whiskey provides speaking another language.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
What? Like drinking whiskey Booth speaking another language.
Speaking another language. Yeah.
No, but we are talking not about drinking. We are talking about learning another language to make your memory better. No, but está comprobado que aprender otro idioma, not necessarily English, but learn another language evita Alzheimer. So it helps. It helps. Yeah. So, no, no,
no
es,
de,
you know, a lie.
No. Ya de por sí no se me olvidan las cosas malas, mis, con eso menos.
No, lo que pasa es que crea esto, crea las sinapsis, you know, between las
mire,
neuronas.
Mire, mis, ya de por sí las mujeres no olvidamos muchas cosas, ya con eso menos, mis. Aprendiendo tu idioma, no.
Tiene una memoria arranque, digamos.
No necesariamente.
Las niñas tienen una memoria arranque.
I think it really depends on everybody. Yo tengo memoria a corto plazo, so I have short-term memory.
No,
I forget everything
De nación, las mujeres tienen memoria arranque más grande.
No le creo. Ajá.
No, I mean, seriously.
¿Se acuerdan de lo que le hicieron en 2005, si es posible?
That's selective memory.
No, desde mucho antes.
Okay. Bueno, vaya
mucho
a ver.
Mucho antes, okay. Guys,
entonces me voy a poner a aprender cosas italiano y todo lo demás.
No, but it's good. We should. And guys, number 7. When was the last time you got a gift? ¿Qué recibieron? What did you get as your last gift? What do you remember?
And they modern.
Okay. What did you get? But what did you get?
A little gift.
Chocolate, flowers, candy, okay, flowers.
Chocolate. Okay. Kisses.
Oh, like the little
kisses,
chocolate.
Muchos kisses.
The not chocolate.
Muchos kisses.
Yeah, the candy.
Beso. No, beso.
I'm thinking about the chocolate. Estoy pensando en los chocolates que se llaman kiss, you know?
No.
I'm thinking about chocolate. Okay. I'm glad.
Kisses to my children.
Ah, okay, cool. What about the rest? What did you get? Well, Lupe, what did you get? What was your last gift?
The last week, I get earphones.
Earphones, entonces. Earphones. You got, wow, very nice. De los regalos. Now that's good. All right. What about the rest? What was your last gift? Marvin's. Oh, Natalie, Carlos, Moses, guys, no sé si están por acá. Brian, Angel. What was your last gift?
Daddy. In my case, the denture.
Oh, a t-shirt.
Sí, yeah. Okay. My brother.
Okay. I am sure it was a black t-shirt.
No.
What color?
No, my brother not like the rock.
Oh, okay.
Is perreo.
I'm black.
Dirty.
Only shirt black.
So it was not a black shirt. Okay.
No.
Okay.
No.
Got
in
it.
In my case, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I like black shirts. And I'm not a fan of rock or anything. Okay, guys, very good. Let's move on a little. And we have this exercise. Transform the negative sentences into positive sentences. So, ya les tenemos negativas. Y tenemos didn't porque son negativas. But, vamos a hacerlas positivas. We are going to make them positive. ¿Qué va a cambiar? What is going to change? No didn't, no le puedo agregar did, ni didn't, ni anything. ¿Y qué hago con el verbo? What do I do with the verb?
Review the last time.
The past.
Yes. Debo de cambiarlo. I need to change the verb in past. y le quito el didn't because I don't need it.
Yes.
Exactly. For example, later. Number one says, she didn't buy that computer. So she, lo opuesto sería,
She bought that computer.
Perfect. She bought that computer. Exactly.
Yes.
So, les voy a dar 3 minutitos. I'll give you 3 minutes para que me completen los ejercicios. From negative to positive. Todas son positivas. And remember, no le agregamos did, ¿ya? Porque no es negativa, no es pregunta. So, no necesita did. Solo verbos en pasado. Made and past. Okay. Let me know. Me avisan si necesitan ayuda. Let me know if you need some clarification. Two more minutes.
Hola.
Thank you, Ingrid, for the confirmation. That was fast. That was really fast. Nice. Good, good.
Break.
Done? Is everybody done?
Yes, I done.
Okay, perfect, perfect. Yeah. Very good. Cool. Okay, guys, so let's check what we have right here. Number one says, she didn't buy the computer. The positive one is, she bought the computer. Number two, we didn't bring that package. What is the opposite?
Bro.
Bro.
Mm-hmm.
Bro.
So we brought the package, right? Sin el did, sin el didn't. Exactly, we brought. Yes. Nosotros lo trajimos,
and three. And the client did call yesterday.
Okay, okay, okay. One more time.
Khaled.
Solo que le vamos a quitar, le vamos a quitar algo. Creo que le escuché un did por ahí. Le quitamos el did. Se lo quitamos. Okay, let me write it down. La voy a escribir. I'm going to write it down para que tengamos mejor visibility. So the client, let me make it.
The client,
okay. Como tenemos didn't, yo no lo necesito porque esa es afirmativa. El didn't solo es para negativos. Entonces, did no me sirve acá. Negativa tampoco. Pero tengo el verbo call. Tengo que hacerlo pasado. So the client call y le agrego ed. Yes, the client called yesterday. Eso es todo. That's it. Eso es todo, amigos. So the client called yesterday.
No
Four. Yes, Pedrina, give me number four.
Right. Okay. The employees read the email.
The employees.
Excellent. Very good.
Now, ¿cómo lo pronunciamos en pasado? Read es present y past is?
Red.
Como el color. El color. Recordémonos el cabello de Ingrid. I love that hair. So, the employees read the email. Leyeron. Exactly. I love your hair. Me parece como sirenita. So I like the color, the red color.
No, you know,
I always dye my hair like red color.
¿En serio?
Qué casualidad que lo que usted me está diciendo me lo dijeron ahora en la mañana también.
Ay, like the Little Mermaid. De la sirenita, de Little Mermaid.
Sí, me dijo una vendedora ahora en la mañana, porque como mi pelo es bien largo.
Can I see?
Es bien largo.
Es que no se nota en la cámara.
Es bien largo.
Ay, sí lo tiene.
Es que...
Oh, my God. Wow. It's really long.
It's long.
Yeah, it's really
kind. Wow. Sí, me llega prácticamente hasta...
To your back, toda la espalda, cool.
Y cabal lo que me dijo usted, me dijo ahora en la mañana una vendedora.
Yeah, like the Little Mermaid. But it's, I really love the color, it's cool. Number five. Don't listen to Danny. Okay. No, just kidding. Number five. Our boss didn't come back last week. Oh, y Norberto?
Our boss? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, guys. Solo que Norbert lo escucho como bien lejos. Creería que es el audífono.
Podría ser.
Es come.
Our boss.
Our boss came.
Yes, exactly. Our boss
came.
Very good. Our boss came back last year. Regresó. Excellent. Our boss came back. Okay. Cool, very good. Number six, not very. Ahora ya está un poco mejor su audio, su micro. ¿Podemos intentar?
No sé, no sé, ¿se escucha?
Es que sí se escucha, solo que es como un poquito lejos, entonces el sonido se escucha como confuso, no sé eco, cómo explicarle. Yeah, a little, but intentemos, let's give it a try. Number six.
Okay, they canceled
the meeting.
Okay, y le agregamos ed, right? Ed. Like this, Norbert?
The meeting.
Norbert, do you have it like this? They canceled the meeting?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Yes, very good. Exactly, they canceled the meeting. That is the one. So no didn't, nothing else. Number seven, que vos no he escuchado today. Marvin, I'm gonna take you. Marvin, do you have number seven?
Hello.
Or Richard, do you have number seven?
Hello.
Anita?
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you, Richard. Number seven,
the lady went to complain.
Went to ladies?
Complain.
Like this?
Yes.
Okay. Solo una cosita, just a little something, Richard. Tenemos el verbo want. Y este es el verbo when. Se parece, pero son diferentes. Yes. So.
Wanted.
Okay. Vamos a hacer un pequeño cambio acá. Y lo cambiamos a wanted. The lady wanted. That is the best. Good. Yeah. El go es when, pero se parece. Solo es una letrita la que cambia. Son bien parecidos. So, went es el pasado de go. Pero want es querer. I want, right? Y el pasado le agregamos a de wanted. Or wanted. The lady wanted. Como cuando se dice, yo quería. No sé.
No de buscar.
Ajá, no, wanted es de... también puede ser como de buscado. No sé si han visto lo que manda a veces la Interpol, el FBI, y dice wanted. Son como buscados, pero buscados. La traducción para nosotros es como querido, de quererte, you know?
Michelle.
De querer agarrar.
Richard.
Una cuestión.
Dígame, tell me.
O sea que en este tipo de ¿cómo le puedo decir? O sea que vamos a meter también el ED.
Sí, porque acá ya tenemos mezclados ambos, regular and irregular. Como no sabemos...
Esa era mi duda, porque igual, vaya, yo lo tomaba como que será pasado. Entonces, normalmente el pasado, o sea, los verbos van a cambiar, pero no me había ubicado en eso, que porque lleva ED, igual con Carl, tenía esa duda.
Sí, lo que sucede es que, como si se recuerda, no hay forma para nosotros de saber si un verbo es regular o irregular. Entonces, lo que toca es aprendérselo, ¿verdad? Y tenemos, por ejemplo, el verbo buy, ¿ok? Entonces, sabemos que el pasado es bought, ¿ya? Sí. No existe buy it, por ejemplo. O tengo bring, el pasado es brought. Significa entonces que bringed, esta palabra, si yo le quiero poner bringed, eso no existe. Lo que pues ni modo, ¿verdad? Toca es aprenderse. O sea,
igual en ese verbo, vaya, si se fija, solo una letra cambia. Bueno, exacto. Solo se le agrega la R nada más.
Ya, porque si se fija acá, por ejemplo, call es un verbo, lo que le llamamos regular. Significa que solo le agrego ed, por eso es regular, porque tiene una base, ¿ya? So call es regular. Rev es irregular porque ni siquiera cambió. Me cambió una letra. Exactly. Pero cancel, yo sí le agregué ed. Entonces significa que call, cancel son verbos regulares. Want es un verbo regular. Entonces acá ya estamos haciendo como independientemente regular o irregular, esto es pasado, right? Entonces toca aprendernos los verbos, yes. Pero super good.
Ese es el problema.
Ah, sí, sí.
I mean, con la práctica usted ya va a saber cuál es el pasado. At the moment, toca a veces irse aprendiendo uno por uno, ¿verdad? Así que no se preocupe. No worries, you're good.
Vamos
por medias. Yeah, I mean, sure. What about number 8? I didn't send a refund to this email. So, what do you have in number 8?
I sent.
Perfect. I sent the refund. Exactly. I sent the refund to this email. And that's it, right? Very good. So, sent. Wanted. Yo quería. Canceled. Came. Read. Called. Very good job. Guys, are we good? Questions? ¿Alguien más tiene alguna preguntita por ahí? Do you have any question? Okay.
No, miss.
Okay. I guess we don't have any. Perfect. Okay. Now, let me go ahead and move to the last activity. Tenemos una actividad pendiente que es hablar de nuestras satisfaction, insatisfaction. Uy, no funciona. Deme un segundo. Eso no quiere. Okay, there we go. It says here, tell a partner a call you had. Pretend the customer was very angry because of a bad service. So you tell your partner all the questions you asked to find a solution. Una de las actividades era hablar de una situación que hayan tenido, ¿ya? Si no se recuerdan, este mismo día escribimos. Tomamos un par de notas, revisa su cuaderno, revisa sus notas. Probablemente ya tengan hecha la actividad here. Lo que vamos a hacer es presentar en parejas, ¿ya? Como una especie de conversación. We are having a conversation. Usted le llama al compañero, un poquito molesto, right? Y le dice, look, I received a really bad service. Imagínense que fue a, no se me ocurre a ningún lugar. You know, nothing comes to my mind. ¿Qué lugares visitan, guys? What places do you visit? Coffee, okay. I went to. Pero en la iglesia no nos vamos a quejar. I don't think we complain. I don't know.
But, yo no creo que él vaya a la iglesia.
Solo se me ocurren restaurantes, diners, coffee places.
Supermarket.
Okay, supermarket. I like it. So imagine that we went to despensa familiar and nos trataron mal. So, ustedes se van a quejar. You are going to complain about the treatment you received.
Claro.
So no vamos a escribirlo. We are not going to write it today because es más spoken, right? Tenemos 5 minutitos. We got only 5 minutes to go for it. And y comenzamos ahorita. And we get started right now. So, please, everybody, let's go. And then we are going to present it. So, let's go. Go. Hello, Pedrina.
Hello, teacher. Es que no oía nada, me tuve que salir.
No me escuchas. Sí, yo creo que... ¿Con quién estaba?
Estaba con Ricardo, con Ingrid.
Pero ya le escucho, I can hear you.
Ahora sí, sí.
Probablemente el internet, a veces el internet nos da como problemas, ¿verdad? O a veces se traba.
Exacto.
No, pero sí le escucho bien. I can hear you well. Yes, yes.
Ya voy a tratar aquí de practicar. Gracias, teacher.
No worries. That's good. Pedrina, no hemos tenido todavía el one-on-one, ¿verdad? O sí, ya lo tuvimos.
Y la, me admiré que fui de las primeras.
Y tenía tarea extra, ¿no? No
le sí, tarea. Usted me dejó y se la mandé un audio.
Ah, vale. Ya lo voy a revisar porque estoy pendiente to check. Okie dokie. Give me one second. Tendría que ya todos estar de regreso, but no me sí, carga.
Ya
hey guys.
Hi, Miss.
Me faltan todavía. I'm still missing okay. some. Okay. Okay, so thanks everybody for coming back. Today was a very productive class, I think. Everybody practiced, everybody, you know. I had a chance to listen to more people, so I'm very happy about it. So I would like to listen to one volunteering pair. ¿Quién quiere ser el tributo de la noche? Who wants to volunteer? Anybody? Only one is fine.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, Richard, thank you very much. Solamente I need one volunteering one, so thank you for that. ¿Con quién estaba Richard? ¿Quién estaba en su grupo? Marvin, right? Richard?
No.
Se me perdió Richard.
No, teacher.
Okay, so Marvin estaba en su grupo y Brian, right?
Sí, Brian.
Okay. Brian, ¿está por acá, Brian? Sí, ahí está.
¿Podrías mandarme el screen?
Ya escuché la voz, la risa distintiva de Brian.
¿Podrías mandarme el screen que lo borré?
No, espérame, lo voy a buscar.
Si quiere que pase el otro grupo. Bueno, que ya no hay tiempo.
No copy.
Pueden improvisar. You can improvise. De eso se trata, ¿no? That's about it.
Casi no, realmente no podemos practicar.
No, but it's okay. You can practice a little.
Acá yo diría que pase otro grupo y quedemos como pendientes para el lunes.
Hablando de chicas.
Okay. No, I think we can do it. I think we can definitely give it a try next week. I mean, still, este tema is very interesting y podemos seguirlo practicando later on. Not a problem. Guys, you know, in respect of your time, les voy a pedir ayuda con su camarita. Help me out with your camera just a little while to take attendance, también para tomarles una captura. Esta es la semana número 3. Terminamos, digamos que casi la otra semana. Terminamos lunes, but pretty much nos falta una semana. El tiempo vuela, guys. So we are flying. Estamos desde 4 meses atrás la salida allá por donde Miss Delgadillo. So, you know, either way.
¿Usted seguirá con nosotros en módulo 5?
I don't know. I cannot give you a yes because yes. I don't know.
La que sí.
I'm not sure.
I pray.
I'm not sure. I pray all for right. this.
Ya nos acostumbramos a usted.
No. Oh,
teacher,
pero
yo siento que no voy a aprender con alguien más.
Es normal.
Brian, lo tengo en la mira, Brian.
Sola,
sí, ahorita, René, ahorita. Anita, Ana Delmi, solo me regala confirmación, por favor.
I am here, teacher.
Yeah, thank you. Brenda. Give me some
information.
Yes, Brian.
Hi.
Thank you, Giovanni. Ahorita, Martín Bondia. Martín is not here. Miriam Claribel, Miriam, la vi hace unos segunditos. Thank you. Renee, I got you, Renee. Gracias por el mensaje. Natalie. Just there. Marvin López, if I can. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you. And Ingrid. No, ahí está. Thank you. Okay, guys, le voy a tomar la foto de la semana 3. I'm going to take the picture for week number 3. Brian, si nos ayuda con la camarita. René, yo sé que está trabajando. I know you're working. Oh, you are working out. Okay. Sandra, yes, I'm happy to see you. Hello.
I am crazy.
So, smile.
Ah, miren a Danis.
One, two, and three.
Sacándose los cachitos.
You're training, no worries. Guys, yes. Solo les voy a pedir su enorme ayuda con las tareas del día de ahora. Terminamos sección 3. Eso significa que ahora tendríamos que terminar toda la sección, toda la actividad número 3, please.
Finish the module 5.
Yeah. Si ya terminaron todo, pues felicidades and thank you so much. Yeah. Y si no, please, intentemos avanzar tanto como podamos, right?
No, es broma.
Que descansen el fin de semana. Have a good one. Sleep well. Ignacio, tenemos one-on-one. Me regala unos minutitos. Yeah, I sleep well. Yes. Rest a lot. Bye, everybody. See you.
Bye. See you.
Enjoy the coffee exam.
Bye-bye. Good weekend.
No, go be in. I know. Bye-bye. See you. Bye-bye. See you. Bye-bye. ¿Qué se me queda ahí? Deme un segundito. Give me just a second. I'm going to... Oh, yes. It's clear. Deme un segundo, me falta alguien. I'm missing somebody. Okay, Ignacio, gracias. Thank you very much. Tenemos el one-on-one y me alegra muchísimo que tengamos ahora sí la oportunidad de tener one-on-one. Unfortunately, el módulo anterior no se pudo, but I'm glad we can make it today. Normally, en el one-on-one revisamos algún tema que esté pendiente, asignamos tarea, you know, we check everything. Y quiero comenzar con parte de mi feedback, ya que tengo la oportunidad. Primero, pues nada, siento que su nivel inglés es muy bueno y atrae bastante vocabulario base. Gracias por estar siempre bien participativo. Like, you participate a lot, you give your examples, and good, porque siento que también el resto del grupo es como, yo también quiero hablar, you know, I want to speak, y me los contagia de ese positivismo. So, I'm super glad about it. Con las tareas siempre veo que me las entrega a tiempo, you know, no he tenido mayor dificultad with your homework, y pues tal vez solo unos minutitos que a veces se me conecta un poquito tarde, pero yo sé que está ahí, you know, por ahí veo su mensaje que ya vino y yo sé que el trabajo a veces pues ni modo nos toma fuera de la casa, ¿verdad? Pero de lo contrario está haciendo un muy buen trabajo, se comunica súper bien, así que solamente de seguirle como metiendo más vocabulario, más fluidez, and then you're just, ya está, you know, pues nadando solito. So, I'm really happy about it. ¿Hay algún tema ahorita que le gustaría que revisemos?
No, particularmente mis preguntas, o mis dos preguntas son sobre la plataforma y sobre el material de apoyo. Uh-huh. Es que no sé, no sé cómo, pues quisiera en realidad descargarlo e imprimir.
No lo he podido descargar.
No puedo. Es decir, he pasado los módulos y no, en los dos no he podido descargar.
Vale, les comento cómo hacerlo. Hay de hecho varias formas de hacerlo. No sé si en el grupo. Permítanme, ahorita busco el grupo. Está en el grupo, ¿verdad? En el nuevo, en el G10.
Sí.
Ok. Los compañeros, no sé si se recuerda que compartieron el material en el grupo, porque de WhatsApp es un poco más fácil descargarlo.
Ajá.
Ahorita lo busco. Hay varias formas de hacerlo. Bueno, de hecho ya lo tengo acá porque no se lo comparto. permítame. ¿Con qué número? ¿Cuáles son los dos primeros números de su teléfono?
Teléfono 7852.
78. No lo encuentro.
7852-4936.
Pero no lo encuentro en el grupo. Deme un momento, mejor lo hago de forma directa y se lo mando ahorita mismo para que ya nos quede eso solventado. So, 78. Anótemelo en el chat porque queda grabado, por favor. Just in case. Por si acaso.
Sí, sí, sí.
Ok, ahorita. So, hay de forma general hay dos formas de hacerlo. Normalmente nosotros, ya lo tengo acá. Ok. Nosotros normalmente tenemos en la plataforma la opción de poder verlo, ¿verdad? Y también ahí se puede descargar. Y la otra forma, ahí está. Y la otra forma es, nosotros lo compartimos al inicio del módulo para que usted lo tenga guardadito también. Y de esa forma le sea más fácil descargarlo. Ahorita se lo estoy compartiendo y solamente se conecta a WhatsApp web y de ahí ya lo tiene como a la mano, lo puede ver digital, lo puede ver como de forma digital o en el teléfono o en una laptop o lo descarga y lo imprime. Yo soy un poco old school, entonces yo sí prefiero tener como materiales impresos, lápiz, cuaderno. Ahorita se lo estoy mandando, ya le va a cargar.
Muy bien.
¿Y con la plataforma, con algún ejercicio que tenga dificultades?
Sí, por ejemplo, en realidad en la tercera tarea, en la tarea número 3 de esta semana.
Ok, ahorita le... En la 13, ok. Ahorita le muestro para que me indique dónde.
Gracias, ya llegó el archivo.
Perfecto. Bueno, ahorita le muestro. Estamos en la sección 3. Acá está. Section 3, Customer Service. La tarea 3 sería la sesión número 13. Yes, no questions. Estamos hablando de esta, ¿verdad? Create yes, no questions, sí, based on the answers provided. Okay. Uh-huh.
Y es en la número 3 y 4.
En la 3 y 4. Ok. Yes, I did. I went to the meeting. And yes, he did. He bought a car yesterday. Ok. En la número 3, ¿cuál es la respuesta que usted tiene ahorita? ¿O cuál es la que no le acepta el sistema?
Porque es de convertir, pasarla a negativo.
En este caso, no. Creería que me está... Estamos confundiendo dos. Creería que sería la 14, no, permítame, la 15, la del día de ahora, como el ejercicio que hicimos. Esa es la número 15 es la que dice, la que les explicaba el día de ayer, que vamos a hacer la negativa. Pero este, si usted le pone un poquito de atención, es similar al ejercicio que acabamos de realizar.
Exacto.
El ejercicio, el 13 que usted me comenta, la instrucción nos dice create yes, no questions based on the answers. En otras palabras, yo tengo esta respuesta, yes, I did, I sent the email, y yo voy a escribir la pregunta acá. So, por ejemplo, enviaste el email. La respuesta es yes, I did. I sent the email. Entonces, esta solo es una pregunta de sí o no. En el ejercicio número 3, es una pregunta la que vamos a escribir, donde vamos a responder yes, I did. I went to the meeting. Si yo le digo yes, I went to the meeting, ¿qué le pregunté? What was the question?
Ok, si fue a la reunión.
Exacto. ¿Cómo preguntaría eso? ¿Cómo se pregunta fue a la reunión?
Did you win?
Pero el verbo no lo cambiamos. Recordemos que el verbo siempre va en presente. So, did you?
Did you go?
Yes, exactly. Eso es todo. Es la pregunta. So intent it. Give it a try. Y con la número 4 es lo mismo. Again, el verbo no lo cambio. Dice, yes, he did. He bought a car yesterday. ¿Cuál fue la pregunta?
Yes, si compró ayer el carro. Exacto. Entonces, la pregunta sería... did he buy a car yesterday?
Yes, very good. Yeah. Eso es todo. That would be it. Solo como buena práctica, siempre iniciemos con letra mayúscula para que no le vaya a tomar el sistema como incorrecto, ¿verdad? Y cualquier cosa, si no le funciona, let me know para poder ver de qué otra manera. A veces un espacio, una coma, algo se nos va y por eso es que no nos la toma. Pero sí, son preguntitas. Ok.
Muy bien.
So, let me know si tiene más dudas. Igual yo me duermo bastante tarde, así que you can text me if you need anything else.
Descanse.
All right. Gracias, Ignacio, gracias por su tiempo. I'll see you tomorrow. No, I'll see you too. I'll see you tomorrow. See you Monday. Descanse. Bye bye.